think in pictures. Pictures is my first language, and, you know, English is my second language. When I read a book, I translate it into a movie in my head, complete with pictures and sound. It's as if you took a video camera and you just plugged it in right here, and you could just play the whole finished thing real. I can be a cow walking through that system. I can be a person walking up and down the catwalk. I could be in a helicopter over the system. It's just that simple. It's just like having a videotape of it in your head. People get all excited about the virtual reality things that they're doing now on computers. I can't be excited about that. It's like just cartoon garbage compared to what I can do. Nature is harsh. You know, a modern slaughterhouse is much more gentle than nature is. And you've all probably watched these things on National Geographic. Some lion is eating somebody's guts out. When I get old and die, I'd much rather go to one of my meatpacking plants than have a lion eat my guts out. I was extremely oversensitive to sound and oversensitive to touch. Too much touch hurt. Certain loud noises hurt my ears like a dentist drill going right through my head, like a jackhammer in my ear. I can remember flinging myself down on the floor and crying. Scratchy petticoats felt like sandpaper just rubbing off raw nerve endings. School bells. It was like an overwhelming tidal wave of stimulation. Be like being in a pinball machine. I can also remember the frustration of not being able to talk. I could understand what people said to me if they talked slowly, but I couldn't get my words out. Sometimes I'd throw a tantrum because screaming was the only way I could talk. I started getting these terrible anxiety attacks. One of the things is I didn't realize that, you know, my senses were different. I mean, I thought somehow other people were just better and stronger and able to tolerate these things better. It felt like a constant state of stage fright all the time for no reason. When I went out and visited my aunt's ranch, they would put the cattle in a device called squeeze chute for veterinary work. I noticed when the animals went in the squeeze chute that some of the cattle kind of relaxed. And I was desperate for relief from this terrible, constant anxiety I had. And so I thought, well, I wonder what happened if I got in there. So I talked my aunt into putting me in the squeeze chute. And it wasn't very comfortable, but the pressure actually calmed down my nerves. And for 45 minutes after being in the squeeze chute, I was calm. So I started reviewing the scientific literature. And since then, working on development of more humane restraint devices, I find that if you put just the right amount of pressure on the cattle, and it's like all over their body, and it's not too tight and it's not too loose, the animal will just kind of relax. If you make it too tight, it hurts. If you don't make it tight enough, then he doesn't feel held and he fights it.
And if I let the soothing feeling just wash over me, any bad thoughts in my head, it just gets rid of them. You know, you have to feel that nice feeling of being held in order to have nice, kind thoughts. Sometimes I look at it sort of as a neurotransmitter adjustment. I've got to get the good neurotransmitters going in my brain.
But I have to think about making myself relax. I almost talk to myself when I'm in it. I just kind of just keep saying to myself, you gotta just give in to it. Completely let go. Gotta just completely give in to it. Of course, a lot of the psychologists, you know, wanted to take it away from me when I was in high school and college. They wanted me to give it up so I'd be sort of, quote, more normal. Oh, they just made up all kinds of Freudian nonsense, and I wouldn't give it up. And I'm glad I didn't. A lot of autistic people are attracted to interesting visual things. Things that move. When I was a little kid, I loved flags. Lots of autistic kids love flags.
Well, recently, there's been a great deal of careful research and study into the subject of the accuracy of the senses, and the results have been quite amazing. The scientist, Adelbert Ames, has developed